can tell that I'm not very sophisticated. Because here's a bottle of Adidas. Hey everybody, this video is going to be just a little bit different. These are some of my colognes. Let me rephrase that. These are my current colognes. Over the decades, I've tried quite a few colognes. My favorite, I guess. I don't even have any more. It's Polo. And with Christmas time approaching, I hope to score some Polo. And when I do, I'm just gonna maybe get rid of these, or at the very least put those back in the very back, because back in the day I used to rock the Polo, and since that time there's been other flavors of Polo that's been released. The one that I liked was in the green bottle, the first one, the classic. But since then, there's been blue and red and black. And I'm kind of hoping that I can get like a set that has each of those in it, the small bottles. But over the years, I've been using these and some others that I ran out of. And I noticed the sound that this little bottle of Bond number 9 makes when I clink it against others. So if you're thinking, well, how strange that this guy is making these sounds, but you have to remember this is a relaxation channel. It's not a product review. Now, out of these, some of them I like and some not so much. Like this one here, Lagerfeld Classic. This came out back in 1978. It's kind of a what they would call an oriental woodsy fragrance. And I do like this one, and my wife seems to like it. Here's a small bottle of Obsession for Men. I used to have a much larger bottle, like 4 ounces or so. But I used it all up. Now this, I guess you would call it kind of a citrus type smell. Kind of like a, it almost smells like it has like tangerine and lime and, I don't know, grapefruit in it. But it has some other smells to it, like maybe cinnamon, jasmine. This came out in, I'm wanting to say the mid-1980s, I think. 85, maybe 86. It was pretty popular back then. I don't know how popular this would be today. That's Obsession for Men. And it's just a little bitty bottle. This one here is Gray Flannel. It's by Jeffrey Bean. And kind of like the Lagerfeld, the Gray Flannel is kind of a woodsy fragrance. I guess you would call it an oriental woodsy fragrance. And this has been around a really long time. This came out back in the 70s. And I haven't used very much. Let me take a whiff of that. And it's really, really strong. But it's definitely been around a long time. Mid-70s. And this little one here, which I haven't used very much of either. This is a Halston Z14. And it's kind of a leather fragrance. And it's got some other stuff in it, I guess. But a little bit of lemon, a hint of lemon. Some other stuff, I'm sure. And it's been around pretty long time, since the mid-1970s also. Halston Z14. Out of all of these, this little one here is the one I think I like the most. And so, Dracar Noir. I'm not sure if I pronounced it right or not. It does smell really good. This was made by Guy LaRoche. And this came out in the early 1980s. And it's what you would call a, I'm trying to remember the word. It's a French word, kind of like for fern. Fuchsia, I think. But I like it quite a bit. That's probably why there's not much left in it. What else do I have here? There's a bottle of Pierre Cardin. And I'm not French, so if I mispronounce any of these, my sincere apologies. Let me smell this. And it's not bad. I've worn this several times. It's been around a long time. This is a Pierre Cardin Pour Monsieur. It's kind of a woody, spicy fragrance, I guess. Maybe there's a hint of a orange, a lavender in it. And it's hard for me to describe these because I'm not an expert on any of this. By far not an expert. But nor N-O-I-R. It's a French word that means black. But in regards to people, it means dangerously sexy, or maybe mysterious, or dark, elusive, maybe even alluring. So I wouldn't mind having another little bottle of this too, I guess. This is Bond number 9, Fire Island. Let me smell this. It's been a while since I've smelled this. Yeah, that's not bad. I'm not sure what to say about this. That fire, it says New York, Fire Island, and, you know, near New York, there is an island that they call Fire Island, and a lot of New Yorkers spend their weekends there, enjoying the beaches and whatnot. And this might actually be my, out of all of these old-fashioned, all these old-fashioned fragrances, this might be the newest one I have. And this came out in the mid-2000s, 2005 or maybe 2006. But it sure does make a nice sound. Only on an ASMR channel would you use the sentence that this cologne makes a nice sound. Now, you can tell that I'm not very sophisticated because here's a bottle. Adidas. And this probably gets a bad rap, but it's not too bad. It's inexpensive. It's not bad at all. You know, if you're going to go play tennis or something like that, you can splash a little bit of this on, or if you're going to go to the golf course or whatever. But yeah, I know it's a cologne put out by a German shoe company, but I'm not really sure when this was released. But it's not bad, so try not to knock it, I guess. What else do I have here? What haven't I talked about? Here's a cologne by Paul Sebastian. It's got the bottle that's got the his initials on it, P.S. This came out in the 70s, in the very late 70s. 78, 79, somewhere around that area. Let me take a smell of this. It kind of smells like lavender, maybe nutmeg. It's not too bad. So I've got Bond number 9, Fire Island, Dracar Noir, Graf Lanel, Paul Sebastian, Halston Z14, Obsession for Men. And by the way, the Obsession for Men, I think, came out a year after the female version of Obsession. And there's the Lagerfeld classic that I like a lot. So, yeah. Like I said, Christmas is coming. And I think I'm going to go back to using my all-time favorite. Some of you may find it humorous, but Polo is what I used to rock, you know. I think I'll go back to that. I've never tried the polo red or the black or the blue because I don't remember those back in the day. It was just the polo that came in the green bottle with a gold top. Anyhow, this was a little bit different, and I hope you enjoyed this. I'm really not sure what else to say about colognes. I've got kind of a mixture here of some oldies, but goodies, and I've got the surprise Adidas. And off to the side, I didn't put it in the video, I just remembered. A little bit of a Tommy Bahama. Yeah, that smells. I don't know what to say about that. I'll reserve judgment. So anyway, thanks for watching.